Hi everyone, welcome back to the second part of the tutorial for Pack Charlotte. I hope all of you had a relative ease in completing the chart A now with the help of the tutorial. So when we finished chart A, we would have ended our stitch here. Now we do a row of single crochet on the back side, on the wrong side, and come to the beginning of the piece. So we have done SC from here, one stitch in each, all the way to the start. Now either you can change color before you do the SC or after, doesn't matter. Or if you're using same color, you can continue with the same color without changing. Now here the chart B uses different sets of stitches. Now earlier when we did chart A, let me move this piece a bit. Yeah, earlier when we used chart A, we used 5 from the foundation chain, and on the right side, when I counted for one repeat on the right side, I had 7 stitches mark the end of a repeat here, and here it was 5 and on the top it was 7. Now for chart B, on the bottom it's going to be 10 stitches and on the top it's going to be 15 rows. So here it'll be 10 and on the top it'll be 15. Now the first instruction for chart B says for row and it's marked as row 3. So this is the entire chart A was row 1. Now this is row 2. The SC that you did and came back, that is row 2. Now this is row 3. Now the row 3 here, I did chain 9, because now I'm going to do a link 8 treble. This is my upper stitch, so I did chain 9. From the second stitch, I picked up 1 in the back side of the chain. So I have 8 loops on the hook. My first loop is not counted, is not shown in the chart. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Including the beginning loop, it's 9. But the chart does not show that. The chart only shows these 8 loops. So the 8 loops, each square on the chart B shows 1 stitch. So this is 8. Now I'm going to connect to this single crochet. I'm going to insert my hook, yarn over, pull up a loop. This is going to be the same as your return pass that you have worked. So yarn over, pull through 2, repeat all the way till you come to the beginning of the row. So this is one row of chart B which I have completed. So what I did here was SC from this corner all the way till here. Then I did chain 9. From the second chain, insert hook, pick up loop, 8 loops. The 9th loop, I go here. The loop which is on the hook, not counted, not mentioned in the chart. So this is not going to be counted at all. In chart B, I am having apart from the purple one which indicates the short row, I have 2 other colors indicated, which is the black and gray. The black small triangle indicates that I need to have a yarn over, and the gray which connects 2 squares indicates that I'm going to have a decrease. Yarn over is basically increasing a stitch, and a decrease is decreasing a stitch. So decrease requires 2 stitches to be worked into. Yarn over, I'm simply putting a loop of yarn around the hook, and when I come back, when I use that particular stitch, I'm going to increase a stitch in that particular spot. So let's see how we do that. Now chart B says has three blocks of white square, which is simple Tunisian or Tunisian simple stitch. So do not count the one on the hook. So insert into the second, call that as 1, 2, and 3. So these refer to the 3 boxes which are there on the chart B. Okay, on top of the column 2, I have 3 boxes. Now I yarn over. I have a black triangle, therefore I yarn over. Yarn over without doing anything. Next, I have 2 gray boxes. So I pick up the horizontal bar, or the what in this case horizontal. Normally we call Tunisian vertical bar. So I pick up the vertical bar, no yarn over, no pull through, insert the hook into the next vertical bar as well. Now I yarn over and pull through both as if they were one. So if you look at it, that is one decrease made. So the normal Tunisian simple stitch, one in each, will look like this, right? When I do a decrease, I am pulling both the vertical bars together. So I have 1, 2, 3, yarn over, decrease, then again 3. So 1, 2, and 3. Now after I do the third one, I go into the SC. So I insert hook, yarn over, pull up a loop. Now I've connected this row to the SC row. Now it's return pass. So yarn over, pull through 2, all the way till I have one loop in my hook. I'll show you how the yarn over looks like after this row is completed. I'll pick it up and show. So I have, this was the loop which was in the hook, so not counted. 1, 2, 3. If you notice, the yarn over has gone to the back of the loop, so it's hiding behind. Okay, this one. And how do I know it's a decrease? Here you'll see the two stitches together, appearing together, these two. These two have one stitch in them now. So when I go into the next row, I have to pick up 4 loops before I yarn over now. So do not count the one on the hook. 1, 2, 3. Now the fourth one is going to be the previous row yarn over. Like I told you, it's hiding behind. So just gently nudge it so it will come in front. Insert, yarn over, pull through. After you have 4, now I yarn over. Now the previous decrease, that and the next are now going to be decreased together. So yarn over, pull through 2. Next again, I left with 2 stitches here. So insert and pull up for loop, 2. Now go into the SC, insert, yarn over, pull up. So now if I count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So if I do not count this loop, which was already on the hook, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So the yarn over and the decrease are done to maintain the same number of stitches every row. So here I yarn over, pull through 2. Come back to the beginning. I have 1 loop on the hook. Do not count this. Now I'm going to go and pick up 5 loops. So 1, 2, 3, 4. The fifth one will be the yarn over which was done. So it's, if you notice, you can see it, it's gone like this somewhat to the top. So use your hook, gently bring it out. Now yarn over, pull up a loop. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now yarn over. The previous decrease, insert, do not do anything. Again, insert hook into the next stitch. So I have 2 vertical bars inserted, the hook is inserted. Yarn over, pull through both of them. A decrease made. Now I have only 1 stitch here left. So insert hook, yarn over, pull up a loop. Now go into the SC, insert, yarn over, pull up. Now I'm ready to do the reverse. Let's count if I have the same number of stitches. Do not count this. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9. So there is no change in the number of stitches because of the decrease. We did a yarn over to compensate for the decrease. So the pattern of an eyelet is created in combination with both the yarn over and the decrease. So if you notice, you can see here how the decrease is slanting towards my left. So I had a decrease here, then the decrease here, then the decrease here, and the decrease here. Similarly, I had a eyelet here, eyelet here, eyelet here. Now this is the last of the eyelet row now for now. So now I'm going to pick up 6 loops. 1 2 3 4 5. The sixth one is a yarn over from the previous row. So gently nudge it in front, then yarn over and pull up. So I had 1 2 3 4 5 6 yarn over. Now it's a decrease. So I do a decrease from the previous row decrease and the next adjacent bar, yarn over, pull up a loop, and that's it. I don't have any other stitch over here. Straight away I go into the SC, yarn over, pull up a loop. Chart B needs a little bit more focus than chart A, but I'm sure that with practice, as you keep doing it, you'll be able to finish. So this is the first section of chart B, where I have done a yarn over and a decrease, but the number of stitches have been maintained the same because of the combination. The yarn overs have given me gap and the decrease has leaned towards the left. Now what I need to do are 5 short rows. In chart A, we did short row, full row, we did a short row, we did a full row, and again a short row. Now for chart B, I need to do 5 short rows before I come back to the SC row. Now let's see how those short rows are done. The short rows are indicated in the chart with the purple symbol on the chart. So whenever you see a purple symbol, it means that it's a short row. Another indication for the short row is on top of that particular column, the designer has given the number of loops that need to be there on the short row. So if you look at the chart right now, it shows you 3 4 5 4 3. So in the first short row I have 3 stitches, in the second short row I have 4 stitches, in the next short row I have 5, then I go in the reverse order, 4 and 3. So that's how I have 5 short rows. So first 3, do not count this. So 1 2 3, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2. So this is the first short row done. The next short row says 4, right? So now what will I do? 1 2. The third one is the one where I need to go through 2 loops so that I avoid the gap. Okay, so take 2 loops, insert, yarn over, pull up. Now I need to have one more. So for that one more, I go one row below and pick up one loop. So now I have, don't count the loop on the hook, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now yarn over, pull through 2. Yarn over and pull through 2 again, and one more time till you come to the end of the row. So now I had 3, first I did 3, now I've done 4, now I need to do 5. So insert in the first, in the second vertex, first one is on the loop, so second will become the first now. 1 2 3. The fourth one will be the last of the previous row. So take 2 loops, yarn over, pull up a loop. Now go into one row below, insert hook, yarn over, pull up a loop. So So if you leave off the first, I have 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Yarn over, pull through 2. Yarn over, pull through 2. Keep repeating till you come to the beginning of the row. So I'll keep it down so that you can see how the short row looks like when I've done. So now you can see a sort of a pattern emerging. You have a decrease going this way and you have a short row which shapes this way, right? So now I need to finish the short rows part. So I've done 5. The next one is just 4. So 1, 2, 3 and 4. So now I'm leaving off the fifth one which was in the previous row. Only 4. And yarn over, pull through 2 till you get back. Now I need only 3. 1, 2, 3. Yarn over, pull through 2. Twice, 3 times. So my short row is over. So I had a full Tunisian row. When I started, I did chain 9. I had a linked 8 treble row. That was nothing but the full Tunisian row connecting to the SC. Then from then, I had a combination of yarn over and decrease for this one. It's 3, 4, 5 and 6. So 4 rows where I had yarn over and decrease. Then I had 5 rows in which are short rows. So I did 3, 4, 5, 4 and 3. Once that is done, now I'm going to come all the way down and join over here. This is going to be my full row. So here, I just pick up the loops back. 8 loops should be picked up, not counting this. 1, 2, 3. Make sure in the short row you go through 2 loops. 3. Now the fourth one, I go 1 row below. 4. Again, 1 row below for the 5th loop. 6th loop, now I have it here. 7th will be the yarn over which is hiding behind. 7 and 8. Not including the loop on the hook, I have picked up 8 stitches. That brings me to the SC row. So insert into the next SC, yarn over, pull up a loop. Now return pass, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2. Keep repeating this yarn over and pulling through 2 loops till you come to the beginning of the row where you are left with 1 loop on the hook. So this is one half of chart B. So I've done the decrease, I've done the short rows and I've connected it back. Now this yarn over decrease is mirrored on the other half. Now let's see what that means. So here when I did this portion, I did yarn over and then decrease. On this side now, I will decrease and then yarn over. That is the only change. So now I will pick up 5 loops, not 6, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, decrease. So decrease is nothing but putting the hook in the next vertical bar, again putting the hook in the adjacent vertical bar, yarn over, pull through. Okay, so I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, decrease, yarn over. I have one last loop here and go into the SE. Yarn over, pull through 2. Keep repeating till you end up at the beginning of the row with just one loop on the hook. Now I need to pick up 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Now comes a decrease. So vertical bar, second vertical bar, yarn over, pull through 2, decrease made. Now yarn over. Can you see the yarn over which has gone to the side? Insert, pull up a loop, go into the next vertical bar. Go into the next vertical bar, yarn over, pull through. Now go into the SC. Now it's a return pass, yarn over, pull through 2. Keep going till you have just one loop on the hook. Okay, so I picked up 5, then I picked up 4. Now I'm going to pick up 3. 1, 2, 3. Once the 3 is picked up, decrease, yarn over, and then the next yarn over is there. So insert hook, yarn over, pull up a loop. 2 more are left. 1, oops, 2, go into the SC, yarn over, now pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2, just keep repeating the same process, yarn over, pull through 2, take off 2 loops at a time till you come to the beginning. Now I have to insert through 2 loops. 1, 2, perform a decrease, insert the hook into adjacent bars, yarn over, pull through as if they were 1, now yarn over and pick up the loop. 1, 2, 3 and 4. And now go into the SC row, insert hook, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through 2, keep going, removing 2 loops at a time, yarn over, pull through 2 loops, yarn over, pull through 2 loops, and that's it. This is one repeat of chart B. So can you see? You can see the eyelet formed here and the eyelet going up. Here the eyelet is coming down and here it's going up. Okay, this is the pattern. Now this is a short row in between here. These are my full rows and I have, so if I count this side, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So here 15 rows and here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 10 SE here get connected and on that side I have 15. This is my chart B. Okay. Don't forget to post any questions if you have any trouble understanding. I will put out the instructions for this chart B in simple English too, so that you can refer to it as you do the chart. Finish this. We have about totally 30 of this repeats to be finished. And once we finish that, we can go on to chart C, which is nothing but I think the pico edging and giving a final touch to our shawls. Thank you.